In this scripting session, we will show you how to create advanced chase effects in edit mode. We will start by showing you a demonstration of three different types of chases, and then take you through the step-by-step of how to create them. The first effect we'll show you how to create is a position chase. Step 1 is to set the position cues for the moving heads. Start by double-clicking on one of the positions to open the position menu. Select the position you'd like to set, and then select the moving heads. In this example, I'm going to select all the moving heads and move them at once. Then, I will move on and edit the new position. Once I press apply, these changes have been saved. Step 2. Create position overrides. Position overrides allow you to tell a particular light to stop following the master track. To create a position override, make a selection in one of the moving head's position tracks, right-click and press Create Position Override. Repeat this step for all of the moving heads that you want to include in the chase. Now it's time to start adding the position cues. Start by adding the position that you'd like the moving heads to move toward, and space these out in time with different sounds in your music. As you can see, I'm also adding a cue in front of the positions I'd like the moving heads to change to. I'll explain this in just a second. Here, I'm placing these cues in the reverse order. This is because I want the lights to change and then hold that position before moving to the next one. In this example, you can see that the moving heads will stay on the neutral position in the master track until they reach the down cue in the position override. Then they will hold in the down position before changing back to the neutral position. Take a look at this example. Now it's time to apply a color chase. Start by making a selection of the duration of the effect across all of the fixtures you'd like to apply the chase to. Then, under Color in the Effects menu, drag the Color Chase effect onto the selection, choose the chase color, and your timing. Now, I will also apply a different position for this effect. And I will rename the new cue to something a little bit more appropriate. Again, I want the position to hold for a while, so I add a duplicate cue further down the track. Let's see how that looks. Now I'll add a standard pulse chase. Again, start by making a selection for the desired duration of the effect. Drop and drag the forward chase cue and then choose the timing. And Soundswitch will automatically apply a pulse chase every quarter beat. I will apply one more position cue and see how that looks. For these and more great tips, check out soundswitch.com.